A costumed serial killer is on the run in Blüdhaven, and only Nightwing can stop him. But to do it, he's going to have to look up an old friend. What'll happen next? Well, let's hop to the pages of Nightwing issue number 80 and find out together, shall we? So then, picking up from where the last issue left off, Dick wakes up from his rather rough previous night to find the police waiting for him at his door. Dick had reported his credit card stolen by those junior pickpockets in the previous issue, but not before he booked a room for one of the other homeless guys who is now dead in a ditch. The cops not only jump to the conclusion that Dick must have killed this man, but that he must have killed several other homeless people in the last couple weeks and months, all who also had their heart stolen from their chest. And I mean, really, let's face it, Dick's kinda whole, you know, young wheelin' and dealin', had a dozen jobs in the last few years, can never stay in the same place for one time, yeah, that might lead people to believe you're a serial killer. What I find particularly interesting about this exchange, beyond the fact that Dick is wearing a Black Canary band shirt, it's that the cops actually know that Dick himself used to be a cop, because this is post-Infinite Frontier and now everyone remembers everything. Lucky for our hero, though, he ends up having the ultimate alibi in the form of Barbara Gordon, who was only at the end of his block before she ended up getting called back to help out with another crisis. This leads to a very funny and very telling little scene wherein the cops ask what Barbara's relationship to Dick are, and neither of them can really answer because neither of them really know right now. Less than lovers, more than friends? The second the detectives are out the door, though, Nightwing and Barbara are ready to pound the pavement and figure out what exactly happened to this dead guy, and especially what happened to his poor kid Elliot, who was with him the night before. To crack this case wide open, though, knowing full well that they're dealing with a young person who is on the run and scared, Dick decides to bring in a ringer in the form of Tim Drake. Ah yes, the former Robin who is kind of adrift right now, with no team book or no solo book to hold him up, but hey, at least he gets talked up to great lengths by Dick here, saying that he probably is the best Robin ever. Tim comes bearing gifts too. It's one of those wallets with a chain so they can't be stolen or pickpocketed from him. Oh, I get it. When Dick wants to wear a wallet chain, it's cool, but when I do it, it isn't. Now, all roads in this strange serial killer investigation lead back to that homeless encampment that Dick had found at the end of the previous issue. The plan is for Tim to go in undercover with Dick's new dog, Haley, because who doesn't love a dog? Find some clues and report back. Tim actually ends up finding Elliot pretty quickly, and to everyone's surprise, he's not that scared. Yeah, he's bummed that his dad is dead, but the homeless in Blüdhaven look out for each other. More now than ever, as it seems that there's some messed up serial killer running around stealing people's hearts, and the hardships don't stop there for the homeless encampment either. It would seem that Blockbuster knows full well the kids in this camp are pickpocketing people, and no profit of crime, no matter how small, doesn't get a small percentage kicked back up to Blockbuster. Luckily, Nightwing and Robin are there to stop the two costumed supervillains, and not only do they beat them up, but they give them a real tongue-lashing too, saying if being D-list supervillain henchmen aren't bad enough, literally shaking down homeless kids for pocket change certainly is. I must admit too, I positively love the panel of these two getting to fight side by side with each other. It reminds me why I miss the Batman and Robin books so much in concert, because of fun action sequences like this. Together, Dick and Tim manage to push back Brutal and Electro, but unfortunately not before someone ends up starting a fire within the homeless encampment. Obviously it wasn't these two because they were busy. But as the comic comes to a close and Nightwing goes out of his way to save some people from some burning wreckage, he ends up coming face to face with the true culprit, Heartless. The deranged and colorful serial killer who it looks like he's already picked his next target in Dick as everything comes to a close. And so that was Nightwing issue number 80, everybody, and if you couldn't tell, this was another really strong issue from Tom Taylor. I love getting to see Dick explore all these relationships he has with all these different members of the Bat Family. I love that someone remembered Tim Drake existed and that he can be a really solid supporting character in a book when he needs to be. In fact, getting to see Nightwing and Robin team up reminded me very much of Nightwing as Batman teaming up with Damian back in the day. I like all the different layers of Blüdhaven we're seeing, from the very poor on the street to the D-list supervillains to Blockbuster and the mayor and everyone else at the top. I love the creepy design of Heartless, and I cannot wait to learn more about what this guy's deal is. Overall, I would give this one a very positive 8 out of 10. Solid, solid stuff from start to finish.
Hey there everyone, Cape Jewel again, and I want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. As always, if you liked what you see, be sure to like, subscribe, comment. It really helps drive engagement and helps me out too. Also, if you are a patron, which you can become for as little as a dollar a month, you will get exclusive content that no one else can ever see, and you'll get to see the Comic Multiverse podcast before anyone else too. You can check out all this and more down in the description. And until next time everyone, this has been Cape Jewel, and I'll see you all next time. Cheers.